Yes, guys. Okay. Now listen, guys. While overriding superclass method in subclass, either we can use same modifier or strong modifier. While overriding superclass method in subclass, either you can use same modifier or strong modifier. Okay. Example, while overriding protected service method of HTTP servlet in its subclass, you can override either with the same protected modifier or strong public modifier. So which is recommended, sir? Overriding with the strong modifier is recommended. Sir, don't I get any compile time error? Definitely you will not get any compile time error. Are you sure, sir? I'm very much sure, guys. Let me prove that one practically. So for example, you take this HTML servlet only. What is the service method? Protected service method. I'm overriding with what? Same protected. So public. Go for recompilation. Compilation is done. Actually you can compile only that servlet also, not a issue. E-dry, tomcat 9.x, bin directory, tomcat 9.exe file. Tomcat 9.exe file. Yeah, server is started, guys. Okay, guys. Right, guys. So, see, after recompilation, if you restart the server, there is no need of recompilation, guys. After modification, you do recompilation. If you restart the server, there is no need of reloading. You can directly test it. HTTP localhost, port number is 2525. What is the application? MIME-APP. Lastly, what is this? Plain URL. Okay, right now I'm dealing with what? HTML URL. Yes, we are getting it or not there? Right, boss. Now listen, there's one more thing. So let me highlight this one. Sir, you are saying public service method. Tell me whether it's a first service method or second service method. It is still called second service method because identify service method based on its parameter types. Don't identify based on its modifier. While overriding, I changed protected modifier to public, guys. Are you getting my point, guys? Okay. Let's see this. So the ultimate conclusion is what? This one was. While overriding the superclass method in subclass, the superclass method in subclass, we can use either same modifier or strong modifier. Okay, strong modifier. Strong is recommended. Super. No doubt, strong is very much recommended, guys. Okay, boss. Next, while overriding, okay, protected service method of. Protected service method of HTTP servlet in our servlet component. Our class acting as the subclass of HTTP servlet. We can use either same modifier protected or strong modifier public. We can use either same modifier protected or strong modifier public. We can use either same modifier protected or strong modifier public. Yes, guys. Are you comfortable with me, guys? Come on. While overriding superclass method in subclass, strong modifier public. What is this? Public is recommended. Public is recommended. Okay, let me talk about one more thing, guys. Suppose you did spell mistake. Compile time, no error. Why, sir? Array, class can have direct methods also, not only overriding methods. So when you will get error after reloading web application, okay, when you try to give the request, it looks for service method. Since the service method is not there, then you will get error, right? Okay, let me try to reload it. 2525, done. Manager app, admin one. Click on it. Mime app, say reload. Say refresh. See, guys, we are getting 405 error. New number has come. Why? Sir, in the servlet component class, it is looking for service method. Not there. It is looking for service method. There are not there. That's why error is coming. So my question is, why to allow at the compile time? Why to get the error at runtime? Compile time itself, we should tell there is a spell mistake. Okay, that's why we have to place one annotation called @override. We have to place one method called what? @override. Are you able to listen my voice, guys? Mohan, check your side. We have to use one annotation called @override. Is that clear, guys? Now tell me, you try to do mistake. You are telling now, hey, compiler, don't treat it as a direct method. Don't treat it as a direct method. Always treat it as inherited and overridden method. So to treat it as a inherited and overridden method, first of all, this method should be there in the super class. Tell me, service one is there in the super class? Tell me, service one is there in the super class or no? So I am asking compiler, don't take it as a direct method. Always take it as inherited and overridden method. So for first of all, to inherit and override, first of all, service one should be there in the super class. Do you think service one is there in the super class? Not there. Do you think service one is there in the super class? Not there. Okay. Compile, guys. What is this? At the rate override. Method does not override or implement a method from a super type. From a super type. Is that clear, guys? Are you getting my point? At the rate overridden, at the rate override. Is solid or not solid? Yes, guys. So this is how we have to think about the story, guys. So here is my service method, guys. javac-d.java. Okay, compilation is over. Here is my manager. mimapp, reload, say refresh. Modi BJP, Rahul INC, Mamata TMC, KCR TRS. I hope you understood this point, guys. HTML servlet.java. These are my three packages. Here is my HTML servlet. Okay, this time, is there any possibility of doing typing mistakes, guys? Okay. Is there any possibility of doing typing mistakes, guys? Earlier, what happened? When you do typing mistakes, at compile time, no error has come. At runtime, error has come. Come on. Because compile time, when you do typing mistakes in the service method, it is being taken as direct method of the class. No, I don't want to present this service at all. Direct method of this class. I want to present it always as what? Inherited and overridden method. To tell to compiler, don't take it as direct method of this class. Always check it out. Inherited and overridden method. We should use the at the rate override annotation or not. Okay. Array in annotation fundamentals class also I discussed this. Did we discuss this one or not there? Okay. So overall it will help you to avoid typing mistake method names of overridden method. Earlier what happened? By mistake if you forget R, if you forget I, if you overlook that. We thought that we typed everything is perfect, but if you overlook that, what happens, guys? What happens? Compiler takes that method as direct method of the class. At runtime, you are getting problem. No, I want to notify that problem at compile time itself. Then we should plus at the rate override annotation. We should place at the rate override annotation. Okay. Yeah, that's at the rate override won't do anything. It's just a guiding message to compiler. To avoid spell mistakes and to notify those mistakes. At compile time itself. Okay. To notify mistakes in compile time itself. Compile time itself. It is recommended to place at the rate override. At the rate override on the top of overridden methods. At the rate override on the top of at the overridden methods. Okay. At the rate override annotation. instructs the compiler. Instruct the compiler. Don't take. What is this? Current method as the direct method of. Don't take current method as the direct method of. Don't take current method as the direct method of class. Current class. Always take it as. Always treat it as. Always treat it as. Okay. Okay. Deepanksha Bari, just now I have shown, if I change to service one at compile time, we got the error, boss. Okay, treat it as inherited and overridden method. Inherited and over. When I'm explaining, please listen. Please listen. Some people are not at all observing. Okay, see this here. What is this error, Mr. Barik? Where were you when I am showing this error? Please focus, guys. Keep your mind and body in control while attending classes. Inherited and overridden method. I don't have any problem to teach same topic for 10 times, but we have to move further. And others should not feel bored also. See, after listening entire Ramayana, this guy is asking, sir, after applying @ override, if I change service method to service one, what happens? Where were you, boss, when I was explaining same thing? Error has come. Okay. Always inherited and overridden method. Okay, if that method is not present in super class, then compile time error will be generated. Okay, compile time error will be generated. Compile time error. Okay. To avoid spell mistake and to notify mistakes, those mistakes at compile time itself, it is recommended to place @ override on the top of overridden methods. Okay, once again, check it out. I wantedly did spell mistake, guys. R is forgotten. We think that service is there, we overlook, right? Now you observe. Because @ override is there, we got error. Saying that I don't find method called service without R, service without R in the super class. Then how can you say it is inherited overridden method? Suppose if I don't write @ override, then what happens? See, this time what happened? Though there is a spell mistake, it is taken as what? Direct method of that class, not inherited overridden method. To tell to a compiler, don't ever take this method as direct method. Always take it as what? Inherited and overridden method. Go for what? @ override. And this makes you more disciplined programmer while writing the method names. That's it. Especially the people who are having typing issues should have this one concept. Okay, now listen. Everyone clear on this? Or still people ask me, show me that practical, this practical. When I present subject, not listening. Later, Shar, show me that, show me this. And feeling that I asked a great question. I have seen this kind of attitude in online classes. They will concentrate here and there. Later, they will feel that I asked a great question. I hope everyone clear on this. Shall I move to next level discussion? Okay, guys. Tell me, this is the second service method, first service method. Right now, what service method? See, if you are listening class, asking solid questions, I welcome, I appreciate also. I'll paste that question, I'll say, this is the right question. But asking the same point, which is already been discussed, which is already been shown practical, indicates you are not listening. That's why those questions are coming. So that gives problem for me and for other students also. Okay, this is not first service method. This is second service method we are having. This is second service method. This is not first service method, guys. This is second service method we are having. Everyone understood my point, guys? Come on. Right. Right, boss. Shall we get into the next level discussion, guys? How to enable auto refresh. How to enable auto refresh on the servlet component generated web page. How to enable auto refresh on the servlet component generated web page. Auto refresh on the servlet component generated web page. Now listen, guys, set content type is one kind of header instruction to browser telling the display received output in so and so format. Similarly, we are having one more instruction, guys. Devash Fande, don't you think multiple methods can't execute? Multiple method can execute on the same object simultaneously, na guys. Okay, before answering this question, everyone please look at this question, guys, which I pasted here. It's a good question. You recollect your multi-threading knowledge, guys. Did they say object is having any lock? No. Did I say service method is having any lock? No. Are you taking any synchronized service method? No. Are you taking any synchronized block within the service method? No. Then why it will look for thread by thread? It will try to execute. It will try to execute all threads together, na guys. Multiple threads simultaneously or not? Let's suppose servlet container takes 5 seconds to execute servlet component and also another request. On one object, multiple threads will start, guys. On one object, multiple threads, scheduling will happen. Scheduling will happen, guys. If lock is applied, one thread at a time. But as of now, any locking, any synchronization, then why are you worrying about one by one? Thread scheduling will happen. Suppose there is 10 seconds only. 10 seconds only. That 10 seconds will be divided into multiple parts, 100 sections. Okay, each thread will execute certain amount of time against next thread. There also certain amount of time again next thread. Like this, thread scheduling will take place. Okay. If you want to see only one thread at a time to execute, then you have to go for synchronization concepts. Good question, boss. How to enable auto refresh on servlet component generated web page? Right. Now tell me. Okay. Yeah. We must work with HTTP's ARLET request and ARLET response objects. Fine. How set content type is giving instruction to browser. Hey browser, display received output as what? So and so format output. Similarly, we can give instruction to browser by using a method called setHeader. SetHeader. And every instruction will have a name, and that name is called a header name. That's why method is setHeader. These instruction to browser from ARLET will be given as header instructions. Header instruction. Why? Because the message is kept in pw.println will become response body, and instructions will become header, response headers. And every header will be having fixed name, guys. What is the fixed name? Refresh. Like this, so many headers are there. Content type is also one header, guys. Refresh. Okay, how much, sir? 10. You can give this 10 as an integer, as a string value. If you use set header method, string value you should give. If you use you want to give the 10 as what? Numeric value. If you want to give the 10 as numeric value, then we have set int header. There's one more header, one more method called set int header. What is the meaning of that? This will give an instruction to browser. Hey browser, okay, enable auto refresh on the web page for every 10 seconds. Enable auto refresh on the web page for every 10 seconds. Everyone understood my point, guys? Okay, here you observe. pw.println br date and time plus new java.util.dateOf plus h1 open, h1 closing. Date and time, new java.util.dateOf, h1 opening and h1 closing. Okay, guys. Millisecond means you divide, boss. What we are giving? Seconds. If you want to pass milliseconds, you divide and pass. 10 by 1000. P. Vinay Kumar, use some common sense, Ra Babu. 10 by 10,000. 10 by 1000 you place. Then milliseconds. You want nanoseconds? Right. Relevant number. Division only you have to do. What it is expecting is in seconds, guys. You want in milliseconds? You divide and pass it. Okay, guys. You divide and pass it. Yeah, this is written only inside HTML ARLET. We enabled only for HTML ARLET generated web page, not for other web pages, because we have written inside the HTML ARLET. So as usually recompilation, as usually reloading. MIME-APP, reload. Come here, save place. See this, I'm not touching the keyboard and mouse, my hands up, check it out. I hope you are able to see my hands in the camera. Just observe here. What is there? 54 is there. 54 is there. After 10 seconds, automatically it becomes what? 04. Okay, 05. Did I touch anything, guys? Wait for 10 seconds. Wait for 10 seconds. 15 has come. Kema, not Kema. Wait for another 10 seconds. 25 has come. So this is how we have to enable that. Suppose if ARLET is talking to it from database and displaying the score, live game score. Then what happened? Without doing refresh, automatically score will be updated or not. Only the thing is Sarlet should give output collected from the database. Anyhow, in the database, updated score will be there. Okay, right. Yes, every 10 seconds, every 10 seconds, P. Vinay Kumar, where is your brain, Rababu? I have given 10 and why are you reading it as 1 second? Vinay Kumar, I am giving last warning, boss. If you continued this kind of listening, stop thinking parallelly. Stop thinking parallelly. Last warning I am giving. Otherwise, I will remove you from the classroom. I have written 10 seconds. I have placed it 10 and you are asking me every 1 second. What can I do? Okay. See, if you are not serious of listening class, get out. But don't irritate in the chat box like this. I have written 10 seconds. I have placed it 10 and this guy is asking every 1 second request goes. Huh? Waste fellow, worst fellow, muddy eater. Can't you read the things what he's writing? How did you complete your engineering, Ra? Worst fellows. When you cannot read the things, how did you complete your engineering? Shame on your universities. Who has given engineering certificate to you people? Once again, come back, everyone. Now listen. For every 10 seconds, browser creates a new request. For every, stop thinking parallelly, listen it carefully. Carefully. I don't hesitate to scold anyone. Whatever you are. If I feel you are not listening class, I don't hesitate to scold. Later, don't feel bad. Okay, now listen. After every 10 seconds, browser generates a new request. That request comes to Sarlet. Okay, after processing request generates the response. Anyhow, every time we are printing new date and time, that system date and time. So that will reflect on the browser. You need not to give the request. Auto refresh is enabled. Like this only, stock market share values will be displayed in the web page. Live game score will be displayed in the web page. Array, when you are watching live game score by opening browser on any website, crickbus.com, okay, definitely what? Every 10 seconds, our score will be updated or not. You don't press any refresh, but score will be updated. Why? Auto refresh is enabled. When Kohli is batting, number of overs, number of runs will be changed. When Pujara or Dravid is batting, come on, what? Okay, number of overs only will be completely changing. Score will not be changing. Because Pujara is another tough batsman to handle, right? He will eat the balls like anything. Come on, guys. 200 balls, 20 runs. 300 balls, 4 runs. He's having more track record compared to Dravid. We thought Dravid is wall, but he is a thick wall. Pujara has become thick wall, right? Great. How to enable auto refresh on Sarlet component? Yes, answer. Give instruction to browser. From Sarlet component using refresh response header okay to enable auto refresh on the current web page. On the generated web page. on the generated web page. Yes, you want to give as a string value, you can do this. Either this or this. These are the two lines of code. Okay. Gives instruction to browser. Gives instruction to browser to enable auto refresh on the web page. On the web page. On the generated web page. For every 10 seconds. For every 10 seconds. That means. Okay, that means the browser generates the request. Request to servlet component automatically for every 10 seconds. Automatically for every 10 seconds. Enjoyed my point here, guys. Automatically for every 10 seconds. This is this, right? Yes. Use cases. Use cases. Displaying live game scores. Okay. Stock market share values. Stock market share values and etc. Displaying live game score, stock market share values and etc. I think you enjoyed my point, guys. Right. Okay. So with these fundamentals are over. Now I would like to go for HTML to servlet communication. Yeah, when I enable auto refresh, some people are thinking that after every 10 seconds, servlet only will send output to browser. No. Without request, no response. Always remember. Without request, no response. Without asking, servlet or server will never deliver anything to browser. Will never deliver anything to browser. Are you understanding my statement, guys? Okay. So for every 10 second request will be generated automatically and that request related response comes to browser. Yes, guys. Right, boss. Here is my HTML to servlet communication, guys. Now tell me. Here HTML components are there to generate the static web pages. Agree with me, guys. Your HTML pages are there to generate the static web pages. Whereas servlet components are there to generate the dynamic web pages. Now I want to have communication between static web pages and dynamic web pages. Yes, we need to go for HTML to servlet communication. See, I want to have an interaction between static and dynamic web pages and vice versa, dynamic and static web pages. All this needs HTML to servlet communication or not? Angle number one. HTML files are pages or component. Any tag based web component is called page, guys. .html file is called page or file or component, your choice. HTML files or pages or components are given to generate the static web pages. Whereas servlet components are given to generate the dynamic web pages. Dynamic web pages. So to get interaction or navigation between static web pages to dynamic web pages and vice versa, we need to go for HTML to servlet communication. We need to go for HTML to servlet communication. So definitely we need to go for HTML to servlet communication. Are you understanding my statement, guys? Right. Okay, this is one angle, guys. Another angle. If you want to provide inputs to servlet component, we need to provide those inputs by using query string. How? I will tell one thing. Listen carefully. We generally provide inputs to servlet component as request parameters by appending query string to the request URL. By appending query string to the request URL. These parameters will be stored into request object automatically. Listen, this is very important. So in servlet component service method, we can read request params using request.getParameter method. Using which method, guys? Request.getParameter method. Okay. Using request.getParameter method. HTTP localhost. Now listen. 2525 MIMAPP HTML URL query string starts with question mark. Syntax should not be questioned. This colon, slashes, colon should not be questioned. That's the syntax. Query string starts with question mark. And we will pass request parameter as key value pairs. SNO is equal to 101. Okay, this is the name of the request parameter. This is the value. Ampersand. SName is equal to Raja. What is this ampersand, sir? Separator between two request parameter. Ampersand SEADD is equal to Hyderabad. This entire thing is called query string. Query string having request params. Okay. Request params. Every request param contains one name and one value. Okay. What is this ampersand symbol, sir? Separator between multiple request parameter. How we use comma, na? comma, first value, comma, second value, comma, third value, comma, like this. Okay. So when this request is generated, guys, okay, they will be stored directly in the request object. They will be stored automatically to the request object. How they will be stored? SNO is equal to 101. SName is equal to Raja. SADD is equal to Hyderabad. Okay. They will be stored automatically to the request object. Okay. Right. So how can we read them in what? In the service method of, come on. Yes, if you want to pass inputs along with the request, you have to pass query string like this. Query string like this. But that's very complex or not, guys? That's very complex or not? Come on. That's a very complex. So as alternate, we should think about. We should think about alternate or not. Definitely, we should think about alternate. That is nothing but form page. In the form page, we'll be having text boxes. We fill up the text boxes. We click the submit button. Then this query string will be formed automatically. This query string will be formed automatically. First, I'm showing bad part. First, I'm showing bad part. Come on. Off knowledge is very danger. Okay, someone is asking, sir, form page is there now. Why are you going like this? Array form page is not there. We have to do it. I don't want to do it. Then you have to go for form page. That form page will be developed using HTML. So that also needs HTML to servlet communication. See the way I'm presenting, Rav, first fellows. HTTP servlet request, RUQ. HTTP servlet response, RES. Okay, RES. Here, how can we read, guys? We can read each request parameter value like this. TSNO is equal to request.getParameter of SNO. But you will get 101 as a string. No, sir, I want as a numeric value. I want it as a numeric value. SNO, integer.parseInt of. Yes, sir. Use one, not auto boxing array, that is string to integer, Rababu, as int value. Remaining two things, no tension, guys. String name, array, these are local variable names. Any name you can take, any name you can take. Okay, request.getParameter. In this place, we must pass request parameter name. What is request parameter name, guys? What is request parameter name? Yes, name. You must pass yes name. Gius Raja. String SADD. Request.getParameter of. SADD. Tell me. Gius Hyderabad. Gius Hyderabad. Like this we can read, guys. But see, this is, anyhow we can do it. Programmer will do it. But appending query string to the URL by remembering the syntax of query string is very complex for end user or not there. Come on, guys. Very complex for end user. What is alternate? Take the support of HTML form page having form component. When you click on the submit button, query string will be generated automatically. Query string will be generated automatically. Come on, guys. Note. The two, who has to do this? In the browser address bar by end user. End user feels heavy to write this itself. If you ask him to write the query string, you will feel more complex or not. End user is a non-technical person. Non-technical person. Okay, if we ask him, to generate request having query string as shown above. To generate request having query string have shown above becomes very problematic. Error prone means possibility of doing mistakes and complex for him. So provide him HTML form page with form components. HTML form page with what? Form components. Come on, guys. Okay. Which generates query string. Query string dynamically on form submission. Which generates query string on form submission. What is this SADD, guys? Request parameter name or not. So this is bad practice, guys. All right. Okay, here is my form page. HTML form page. Number one, number two, number three. Here is my submit button. Here is my submit method. Okay. Tell me. SNO. Okay. Student. Fine. SNO. Name. Next. SADD. Here is my submit button. Okay. Send. Submit. Send request. Here is my submit button. Send request, guys. Tell me. 101. Next, Raja. Next, Hyderabad. Super boss. Now tell me, guys. You click on submit request. That generates query string. Now tell me, guys. This is easy for end user, or typing URL with query string is easy for end user. What is easy for end user, guys? Clicking submit button by clicking on form component, by filling up form components, easy for end user or not? Yes or no? Right. URL with query string. Generates URL with query string. Right. No, don't think that it is not there. It is there. It is there. Come on, guys. But you don't generate. Submit button will take care of it. What is this? This is submit button, guys. This submit button will take care of it. And this is going to be some HTML file, form.html. Right. Now tell me here, guys, what's happening? We need HTML to servlet communication to provide GUI environment for end user to send request without inputs, to send request with inputs. To send request without inputs and with inputs. Sir, why without input, sir? Hyperlinks, boss. Hyperlinks can send requests without inputs or not. Form submit buttons, guys. They will send request with inputs or not. Okay. Generating request to servlet component by typing request URL in the browser address bar is a very complex process. So we use HTML pages or files or components components based web pages as GUI environment pages to send request to GUI environment pages to send request to servlet components either with inputs or without inputs. Okay, with inputs means form submission. Without inputs means hyperlinks. With inputs means form submission. Without inputs means hyperlinks. Enjoyed my point here, guys. With inputs means form submission. Without inputs means hyperlinks, guys. Hyperlinks. Got it, my dears. Enjoyed my point here, guys. When you click on some submit button, generating URL with the query string is not my responsibility. Submit button will take care. So now tell me, this is better option, direct URL typing is better option, or clicking on submit button is better option? That's the one angle. Okay, I don't want to send request with inputs. I want to send request directly. Then also, typing only this URL also complex now, guys. Typing only URL without query string also complex, right? That is also complex. Instead of that, if I provide hyperlinks, that would be really nice or not, guys? With inputs means form is there. Without inputs means hyperlinks are there. So overall, you need not to type URLs in the browser address bar. Tell me, you prefer executing application from command prompt or clicking on icon on the desktop? Clicking on icon on the desktop only, na guys. Same thing here. You will prefer giving request to servlet component either by typing URL in the address bar, either by typing URL in the address bar, or by clicking on hyperlink. What you prefer? Or you will try to send request to servlet component having inputs by typing URL plus query string in the address bar, or by clicking submit button, or by just clicking submit button? Yes, by clicking submit button. I think you convinced. I don't want to present in a normal manner, guys. Okay. This is very complex if you do on our own in the address bar. But this is generated dynamically because we click on submit button. It will be easy or not? It will be easy or not? Come on, guys. Okay. A, this will be generated dynamically. B, that will be stored automatically into request object D. And since request object is visible here, okay, we read from request object. Long back I said we use request object to read inputs that are coming along with the request. Everyone remembered that? Long back I said we use request object to read inputs that are coming along with the request. Everyone remembered that one or not? Yes, guys. Okay. Three approaches of HTML to servlet communication. Three approaches of HTML to servlet communication. Right, guys. What is number one? Using hyperlinks. Using hyperlinks. To send request to servlet component without user supplied data. User supplied data. User means end user supplied data. User supplied data. Example. What are the examples, guys? Get all job openings. Hyperlinks, guys. Yeah, to get all job openings, is there any need of any input value along with the request, guys? Get all job openings. Next, we have inbox. Next, we have inbox. Get all job openings. Then we have inbox. Next, contact us is not a dynamic content. Nah, sorry. So when I click on it, it should go to servlet. It should go to servlet. Come on. So contact us will communicate with another HTML file. No, not required. Okay, boss. Inbox. What is this? What is this? Latest movies. You should list out all the latest movies that are there in the database. So in this kind of situation, we will go for hyperlinks-based HTML to servlet communication. B, using array news using new songs. Yes, that's right. Okay, trending songs. Using form pages. Using form pages to send request. Request to servlet component having end user supplied data as request parameters. As request parameters. As request parameters. Tell me, guys. Student registration, next, login, payments, all these are looking for forms or not? Oh, they are not hyperlinks, sorry. All these are looking for forms or not, guys? Come on. They are not hyperlinks, sorry. They are looking for forms. Yes, that comes under forms based, guys. Student registration form, login form, payment form. This is using this concept, form pages. See, using JavaScript to send request, with or without end user supplied data. That's not major criteria. End user supplied data. With or without end user supplied data. Come on, guys. End user supplied data. Okay. So for various JavaScript events raised on the web pages, comma, web components. Yeah, this is very important, guys. See, when I load the page, automatically all countries should populate into select box. When I select the country, automatically, come on, states of that country should be populated into another select box. When I type the password, I should get a message. Okay, whether it is a weak password or strong password. Request should go to servlet side and it should check whether this is a weak password or strong password. When I type mail ID, you should tell whether email ID is already in utilization or I can choose it or not. Okay, all these are happening for various JavaScript events or not, guys. Okay. Example. Loading all countries into select box when form page is displayed. Is displayed. This is onload event. What event, guys? Onload event. Okay. Populating states into another select box based on the alert select box based on the country that we have chosen in first select box. Based on the country we have chosen in the first select box. Based on the country that we have chosen in the first select box, guys. Come on, guys. Right, what is this? On change event. When you change the country, request should go, should get the states of that selected country, should populate into another select box. On change event. Are you recognizing these examples, guys? Okay. Checking whether typed email ID is available or not during email ID registration. On blur event. What here? On blur. Once text box loses the focus, on blur event will be raised, guys. One text box loses the focus on blur event. That time request should go and servlet should talk to database. Having this email ID already, email is registered or not, it should verify. If already registered, it should throw error. If not registered, it should not throw error. It should say available, please proceed further. I think you are enjoying using JavaScript also. Connected or not? Connected or not? Everyone recognizes hyperlinks and form easy, but you observe very carefully with so there are so many cases. There are so many cases where no hyperlink, no submit button, but request will still go. When you select the country getting states, request is going when you select the item of the select box. Okay, when you type email ID and when you try to go to next select text box, you will get a message. This email ID is already in use. Choose another one and some suggestions will come. Okay, that is also because of JavaScript. There are many places JavaScript will do. Now listen, suppose every website nowadays is giving internal search box. Beside that search box, button will not be there. Only box will be there. We type and we press enter key. Pressing enter key means on click event we will start searching the things. Their request gone with the on click event, right? Fine. So like this we can go for HTML to servlet communication in different approaches, guys. Right, tomorrow when we meet, we will take the first one, then we will take the second one, then we will take the third one. Thoroughly convinced with me, guys? Yes, I will give depth session, no doubt in that. Jagadish, JSP started in the evening hours. Okay, JDBC still not decided. I will let you know. You are asking design pattern, new batch. Once the next slot is free, I will start design pattern. Okay. Yeah, Swaroop Sarkar, you have to learn JavaScript. Otherwise, go and visit na. Devash Pandey, I launched means definitely I will make it now, boss. Right. Ram Science, at the end of February, I am going to start Spring Boot. Saith is using JavaScript validations also can be done. I think with this knowledge, you cannot come for JSP, boss. Swaroop Sarkar, go and watch Naresh IT web page. Free JavaScript and HTML classes are there. Okay. Free JavaScript and HTML classes will be there. Please go and attend. Nikash Paramori, today I have not written any HTML code. Okay, parallel you have to work out HTML code. Naresh IT is conducting free HTML and JavaScript classes. Just look for the batch and go and join. JSP 35 days, guys.